So we have done a lot of work this week with our Let's Go to the Moon, and also if you decide to go to the moon text. Now I want you to tell me, what did you learn after reading the book Let's Go to the Moon? And also maybe you could include some of the information that you learned from this story if you decide to go to the moon. I want you to write a paragraph giving me facts that you learned about going to the moon. Or the moon itself. Now, let's think about this. We know that a paragraph needs to have a main idea. So we need to have a big idea, the most important idea that we're going to be telling our reader about. Lots of times we will start with our main idea, but we don't have to. And then we're going to provide some supporting details about that main idea. We should not go off topic. That's really important. So maybe you want to keep it simple and you want to tell me about spacesuits and how what you learned about spacesuits. So you could say that your main idea is spacesuits are very important for keeping an astronaut safe while on the moon. Your supporting details then would explain how spacesuits keep the astronaut safe while they are on the moon. That way, you can really focus in on those specific things that you learned about. Should I be talking about craters in this paragraph? Oh no, I should not, because this is not about craters. This is about a spacesuit. Remember that when we are writing a main idea and a paragraph, that main idea is our roof. So everything that is underneath, all of those supporting details need to be covered by that roof. I should not go off topic and write about craters because that would make it hey, it's over here. Here's my little roof. Boy, I'm crooked. There's my roof, and here's craters. Craters are going to get wet if it rains. We can't have that. We need to have a main idea that covers everything. But if you would say that, let's see, there are some amazing things on the moon that astronauts have learned about, that's going to be a gigantic main idea. It's going to be too big to write for this paragraph. So what I want you to do is I want you to choose one. Oh, that looks like two. One topic to write about. Make it pretty narrow, but I also need you to write a couple sentences. So I should have a main idea sentence, and then we're at the end of first grade, so let's go for three supporting details. Making that four sentences in this paragraph is what I'm expecting. Your sentences must start with a capital letter. They must end in an end mark. How sad am I going to be if it's one just gigantic blob of words without any punctuation? Oh, I'm going to be so sad. Please don't do it. Make sure when you finish your sentence, you put an end mark. That's really important. We're in first grade. We're almost second graders. We're able to do that now. So you're writing your main idea. You're giving me at least three supporting details. What if you don't have enough details? Well, you can go back to the text. You can listen to the story again. Or you can ask an adult for some help to look up and do a little bit more research about the topic you're most interested in. We are getting fantastic at learning on the computer, and so you can definitely use some websites. And in fact, I've actually included some good kid ones underneath this video. That way, you can do a little research. Read it for yourself or have mom and dad help you with it, and then give me a couple sentences about that topic.